Hello everyone. We had seen in a previous video that before the discovery of Faraday, electric current was only being produced by using chemical reactions. But after his discovery, he had found a very simple method to produce current just by mere moving of the conductor in the magnetic field. So this laid the foundation for making electric generator, which converts mechanical energy into electrical energy. In this video, we'll be learning about the generator and how does it work. So the construction of the generator is quite similar to a motor. Now, just think of reversing the working of the motor. The motor converts electrical energy into mechanical energy. The moment we switch on the current through this armature coil, it starts rotating. Now just think of reversing this functioning. What if I start manually rotating this armature coil? What will happen if I manually rotate this armature coil? Now we had seen in a last video that when a conductor is moved in a magnetic field, current is being induced through it. So basically, if we reverse the functioning of this motor, if we manually move the armature coil, current will be induced in this armature coil, and this will now act like a generator. So let's try to move the armature coil manually and try to find out the direction of induced current in it. Now to find the direction, we have to use Fleming right hand rule. We have to stretch a thumb, a forefinger and second finger in such a way that the thumb points in the direction of motion of the conductor, the forefinger points in the direction of magnetic field, then a second finger will give us the direction of induced current. So let's apply in it. Now, magnetic field is always from north to south. So my finger will be pointing in this direction. And we are rotating the coil in this way. So the movement of AB arm, the right arm, will be in outward direction, this hand. So now the current will be induced in downward direction in the right arm or AB arm. So let's try to find out the current in CD arm also. Now magnetic field is in the same direction, but the movement of CD is inside. So we have to reverse a thumb. This will be like this. Now the middle finger or the second finger will give us the direction of induced current. So in CD arm, current will be induced in upward direction. So you'll find out that current will flow in upward direction in CD arm, and in AB arm it will be induced in downward direction. Now this current produced is taken by using the rings, and those rings are being connected to the carbon brushes, and through those carbon brushes it is taken out for running the electrical appliances. Now if you observe, after half of the rotation, now AB arm will come on the left hand side and the CD arm will go on the right hand side. Now the current in CD arm will reverse because now its direction is outwards. So previously the current was being induced in upward direction, and now the current will be induced in downward direction. This will be the case. It is coming outside and magnetic field is in the same direction, so current will be induced in downward direction. So you will find out that after half of the rotation, the direction of the current is reversing. Now this type of current which reverses its direction in every half rotation is known as alternating current. This is the same current which we use in most of our electrical appliances at our home. Now if we need the direct current or unidirectional current, we have to make certain changes in this arrangement. Now in place of these complete rings, if we use the split rings, the rings which we had used in a motor will get direct current. Let us see how. Now when this right hand side coil will take a half turn, this ring X will get connected to the negative terminal and the ring Y will get to the positive terminal. So we always get the electricity in only one direction. So if we require the production of alternating current, we use the complete rings. And if we require the production of direct current or unidirectional current, we use the split rings. Now we use generally two types of current in our homes. One is direct current and other is alternating current. Mostly all our appliances are based out of alternating current. This is because of the fact that the losses in direct current are very much more than that of in alternating current. That's why all our appliances are made just to work on alternating current. In the next video, we'll be learning that how all our appliances are connected to the power supply and what all safety measures are taken to make us safe from the electric shocks.